We're really glad to get to this portion of the evening with our featured speaker, Dale Jackson. Dale is the husband of Sarah, dad to Camille, Colin, and Gavin. He's a business owner of Jackson Heating and Air and the third largest, which is the third largest train supplier in Georgia. Dale is the chairman of the 3rd District Republican Party. His 8-year-old son, Colin, is autistic. And based on research and the advice of medical professionals, they explored treating Colin with cannabis oil. Dale has been very active recently in speaking out about the fact that in Georgia, cultivation is not allowed at the moment. So he is going to share some of that information with us and his journey and fight for that. So welcome him, please.
Well, so we have, you're giving me an hour and 20 minutes. Trust me, I am way too hungry to go an hour and 20 minutes. I do appreciate y'all affording me the opportunity to come and speak tonight. I would love to spend the last half of it just answering questions, because I don't get the opportunity to speak that often in front of people that may disagree with me. And one thing that I've learned over the last couple of years is this can be controversial. I want to keep it away from being kosher. Now, obviously, it's pretty personal for me, and it is sometimes difficult to keep the emotions out of it. But we're trying to take a very scientific approach, a very limited government, liberty approach. I do have a couple of questions I want to start with. You don't have to raise your hand if you know, or you can speak out. I don't really care. House Bill 1 last year. Is anybody familiar with House Bill 1? Anybody know what it does? What it did? Well, it legalized medical cannabis oil. Anybody know what medical cannabis oil is? Well, but here's my question. Medical cannabis oil is legal in the state of Georgia. But I have a pop quiz for you. Does anybody in this room know where I or anyone registered with the state of Georgia can go to purchase medical cannabis oil?
Colorado.
That is a great guess, and you are 100% wrong.
No.
There is not one single state in our union that I or any other resident of Georgia who has registered with the state, who has gotten a written document from their doctor, who has been approved for medical cannabis oil, there is not one single U.S. territory that we can go to purchase medical cannabis oil. Now, I can't go to Colorado and buy a bag of weed, but I may, just may, be the only person in this battle advocating for medical cannabis oil who has actually never even seen marijuana before. So I wouldn't know where to start in Colorado buying a bag of weed, but I bet it's probably a lot easier there than here. Well, probably not, because it probably can be purchased within a half a mile from here. Matter of fact, statistics say that it can be purchased within a half a mile from here. But is that safe? Is that the best Georgia can do? Is pass a law giving our residents the ability to treat their child, but not give them an avenue to purchase it? Or, better, even worse, to say, well, you can purchase it. Please, just go to another state. Purchase it illegally. Leave that state, break that state's law, break federal law, and then come back here. Now, we don't want you to have it tested in a lab to determine if there's any imperfections in the oil for your child. We want you to fly out to Colorado like my best friend did just yesterday and buy a bag of weed, set up a lab in his hotel room and make cannabis oil. A parent has to make medicine. That's the best Georgia can do. Now, I say that pretty sarcastically, as you may guess. Are there any fans of Obamacare in here? Any? I'll give you a minute to think about it. No fans of Obamacare? Now, wasn't the number one thing that the Republican Party, conservatives of America, the number one complaint about Obamacare? Why do I need government getting in between me and my doctor? I ask you, is this any different? If I have a doctor that tells me he's seen evidence of cannabis oil treating children with seizures, those with MS, those with autism, do we not have a right to try? Earlier it was mentioned a little bit about my family. I can't remember if it was mentioned or not, but just to add a little bit of irony to the situation, I'm really good friends with my sheriff. And my brother-in-law happens to be the head drug agent in Troop County. Now that makes for some interesting dinner conversation. But he's actually on board. But that leads to another part of my discussion tonight. And there's a clock here, so I won't go too long. Yes. My son, Colin. Now many of you maybe know someone. Chances are, statistics say you do know someone that has autism. I doubt very seriously that you know the real world of autism. It's many times not very pretty. Now, we all see in the stories that they post on Facebook how the autistic child, because of X, Y, and Z therapy, just miraculously got better. I've seen those. You know how often I get sent a video from an autistic child that has cannabis oil that all of a sudden began to speak? Every single day. Do you know how bad that hurts a father that's poured 2 years of his life into fighting for a possible option? Do you know how long my wife and I have longed to hear my child say a word? My son is 7 right now. He'll be 8 in just a couple of weeks. Be honest with you. Typically, birthdays aren't very happy occasions. It's always cute. A little 1-year-old that digs into that cake, it's all messy. I'm still waiting on my son to dig into that cake and get messy. It really made me happy. Scientific studies show that after the age of 7, the amount of advancements that an autistic child can make dramatically dwindle. Did I mention that my child is 7? He'll be 8 in a couple of weeks. All the while, we have politicians acting as doctors at the Capitol that are telling me, well, Bill, you know, laws just take time. Laws take time. So before I get into just exactly that process, I want to slow down for a minute, because chances are you are like a large majority of the entire state. And sometimes we forget because I have been neck deep in this for over 2 years. And sometimes a lot of people just don't understand what exactly House Bill 1 was and what exactly House Bill 722 is and why it's important. For starters, now, as I'm sure that our law enforcement officers have pointed out, that it is possible under some scenario for you to get high off of cannabis oil. So I'm not going to try to say that it is impossible. Now, it's important to understand cannabis oil, which could technically be in any strength possible, is a little bit different than the law that was passed in Georgia. House Bill 1 has, you know, certain guidelines, restrictions. So you can only have up to 5% THC. And it has to be at a 1-to-1 ratio. So it also has to contain 5% of CBD. So CBD is a completely innocent and completely legal in all 50 states. CBD, that is an oil that comes from the marijuana plant or a hemp plant, is completely legal. You can generally, I guarantee there's a place here in town that you can go and purchase CBD oil that contains zero THC. THC is obviously what everybody's worried about. But in House Bill 1, the law states that it can be up to 5% THC, but it has to be at a 1-to-1 ratio. And what does that mean? Why is that important? Well, if you have 5% CBD oil, or just CBD, it's a really long word that I don't even really know how to pronounce that well, cannabidiol oils, but it's not oil. Don't get me started. And then you have THC. They cancel each other out as far as getting high. So you can take, under current law, there's absolutely no way that you could get high as long as you had up to 5% THC and 5% CBD. The CBD actually cancels out the euphoric feeling that you would get with the cannabis oil. Now, and then it covers a variety of patients. I don't know them all. Half of them I cannot pronounce, so I will not try. But there are some seizures, and very rare seizures. Cancer, as long as you were literally about to die, you can take cannabis oil under Georgia law. Now, with House Bill 722, we attempted to remove some of those restrictions, because what we found, just like when we tried to pass this law originally in 2014 and it didn't pass, by the time 2015 came around, we had learned a lot more. Well, now we've learned even more. And now we've learned of all sorts of different conditions. And what do they need? A lot of them, and autism would be one of those, requires a very high percentage of THC. So that was some of the things we tried to get added into the bill. Now, do y'all remember that first question I asked you? Where can a resident of Georgia go and legally purchase cannabis oil? Well, 85% of House Bill 722 was giving the state the legal option to do what? To grow. Now, what does that mean? Because that's going to mean something different to probably each and every one of you in this room. Now, most people, when they hear that, they think, doggone, I'm going to get to grow a pot of weed. Well, if you've got a lot of land, you've got roughly about $15 million to invest, if you can fill out the 28-page requirement, if you can provide a security system that probably costs about $500,000 that's directly connected back to the sheriff department, if your sheriff in your county approves of you growing, after you're certified and awarded one of the six licenses in the entire state, then yes, you will be able to grow some weed. Chances are that's not many of you in this room. And it's certainly not going to happen in anybody's backyard. But that's what we were asking for. We were asking for a legal right to provide medicine for our child that the governor signed into law and said we could. Instead, you know what we got? This year, when he took about 50 pages of House Bill 722 and ripped out every word in it that had anything to do with growing, and you know what he replaced it with? You know, if I wasn't about to tell you the truth, this would be funny. He gave immunity. The governor of Georgia gave immunity to a manufacturer in Colorado. This is a Republican Party, right? Mm-hmm. We do understand constitutional law, right? Mm-hmm. Strike that. We understand basic common sense, right? Can the governor of Georgia provide immunity for anybody in the state of Colorado? Especially when it comes to breaking federal law. I guarantee you that manufacturer does not give a hoot who Governor Deal is. He's concerned about President Obama and the Department of Justice. But thankfully, our governor ripped out cultivation and gave a citizen, a corporation in Colorado immunity. If we were doing our job correctly, they would be too embarrassed to put that in the law. That's a shame. And I guarantee you that maybe because the Speaker of the House actually sent it out in a memo and was championing the idea and encouraged all 180 state representatives to put that in your newsletter back to your constituents at home. Let them know that we provided immunity for parents of Georgia in Colorado. You can say what you want to about cannabis oil. You can say that it may lead to something else. But folks, if that's the best we can do in Georgia, if that's the best a state that is almost unanimously controlled by Republicans, if that's the best we can do, dear Lord, why do y'all think that is? Why do you think the number one answer that you would give when you go to the Capitol? Well, you know, laws are complicated. Laws take time to pass. Why is that? Do y'all have any idea how much money lobbyists are putting into politicians' campaigns just because they want to convince them to vote no against House Bill 722? Oh, but wait. Almost that same amount of money is getting put in those same campaigns to try to convince them to vote yes. So don't you think it would be in that politician's best interest? Let's just drag this out a couple of years. Why in the world would that politician want to vote no and pass a bill and be productive when he can continue to get $10,000 this year from this lobbyist and $10,000 from this lobbyist on both ends of the spectrum? Started out talking about THC. Well, as I mentioned, we're learning there's new strains coming out. New strains of the plant, and then new strains that come out of the plant. Do y'all know that there's a particular strain called THCA? Now, as far as the law is concerned, THCA is the exact same thing as THC. There's two things, though, that are important about THCA. One, my son needs THCA, so it's pretty doggone important to me. Do you know what the second important thing about THCA is? Besides the fact that it is completely illegal, you could drink a Mountain Dew bottle full of it and not get high. It does not react in your body anywhere close to the way THC does. But according to law, it's the same thing. So there are those that are battling at the Capitol against a strain that does come from apparently an evil plant God created a long time ago. But I know you heard that before. That cannot get you high. You can take it and you won't be the exact same thing as anybody got high off Advil before? I mean, Tylenol can kill you if you take too much Tylenol. Who would abuse a drug, a medicine that doesn't get you high? It provides no reason to abuse it. I don't know, I'm still asking the same question. I haven't got a good answer yet, but I guess there's somebody out there that would. So, many people know a little bit about my story on Facebook. Apparently I tend to post a lot. But my son is on cannabis oil right now. He started on Thursday, had his first dose. My son is not on the state registry. He is not. We did not get a doctor approval. But I'm here to tell you why that is 100% legal for me and my son. And that was a loophole that our good friends over at the GBI found. Apparently they found it last summer and decided not to tell anybody. I really would have appreciated that they told me. But in our hearing on February the 22nd, when it came time to actually pass the bill out of committee, they knew that finally, that was the day it was going to pass. So they had to bring up the language of the bill. And so, in as simplest terms as I possibly can, because I promise you I've been studying this for 10 days and it is still extremely complicated. So don't feel bad if you have questions at the end. I still have questions. According to Georgia Code, cannabis oil, keep in mind now, we're not talking about a plant. We're only talking about extracts from the plant, just an oil form. Technically, they call it a sample. If it contains less than 15%, then the Georgia Law Code doesn't acknowledge it that it even exists. There is no law against having cannabis oil that is less than 15% THC. Now keep in mind, I need THCA. It can't even get you high. That, we've already went over. We'll do it again. Now, unfortunately, we actually passed House Bill 1 last year. So this is where it kind of gets a little weird. So from 14.9% THC cannabis oil, that's perfectly legal. All the way down until you get to 5%. Now all of a sudden, it's no longer legal for anybody to have. Because we passed House Bill 1. So that's a law. And House Bill 1 states that if you're going to have cannabis oil, if it's going to contain THC up to 5%, then these are the steps you have to go through to be approved to have it. And these are the restrictions and the guidelines that you have to have. So that's pretty big news. Now, I'm totally shocked that everybody's not trying to get this word out there. But the truth is that it is 100% legal. Now, they're going to completely close that loophole if they pass House Bill 722. And the governor has already told us that even if we don't pass House Bill 722, even though it's worthless at this point, then he's going to take that language that closes that loophole and he's going to put it into another bill at the very last minute. And our governor's proven he can do anything he wants. So until we no longer accept that as a state, then that's the way it's going to be. So that's the loophole. It's just on the radio today in Atlanta discussing that. So anybody that you know, let them know that it is 100% legal for any condition whatsoever. Now, you still can't buy it, but it's legal. And so why is it important that we let everybody know that? And why has everyone fought against House Bill 1 last year and House Bill 722 this year? If everybody that could potentially benefit from cannabis oil took advantage of this loophole that's going to be open for the next probably 2 to 3 months and saw the benefits of cannabis oil, they would begin to change their mind. My family, I mean, we're good old Southern Baptists. At least we used to be. We're still good old, we're just not Baptists anymore. Sorry. You know, they completely changed their opinion about marijuana. And that's just human nature. That's who we are. We've been told for 40 years that marijuana is an evil plant, that marijuana is addictive, that you'll die if you don't just say no, according to Barbara Bush. Anybody want to raise their hand and say, and let me know how many people have ever died from marijuana? Marijuana overdose? We're still waiting. Not for you to answer, we're still waiting on the first one. Do y'all want to know the number one cause of death in this country? Accident related? So like not heart disease or cancer. Accidental overdose from FDA approved prescription drugs. That is the number one killer in our country for accidents. Accidental overdose of government approved, pharmacy created drugs. Most of them contain cocaine. In the eyes of the law, cocaine is better than marijuana. I won't go there. So, I know I'm gonna have to close pretty soon. I'm not gonna get go it because I'm on a bottle of water and I'm about to die. But cultivation, why is it important? I'm just one person. And granted, a lot of people comment and stuff on my Facebook page, but every single day, at least since my son started taking cannabis oil, somebody has contacted me and they said, you know, I had no idea that cannabis oil could possibly benefit my son with autism. And that's why we're fighting. Because I don't know every single person in the state. Apparently Facebook's maxes out at 5,000 friends. So, without cultivation, without giving parents a realistic way to get this medicine, There are hundreds of thousands of potential patients that will never get help. And that's why we continue this. Because last year, autism, my son was one of the first things that the governor cut out of the bill. And I continue to fight. This year, for right now, autism is still in the bill. But cultivation was gutted out. And we do not support this bill. Because without cultivation, all we're doing is we're giving the governor and all of the legislators that don't have the courage to stand on their own two feet and vote the way they think they should vote and vote with the 80% of Georgians that believe we should have cultivation. And I'm going to fight against House Bill 722. Do y'all have any idea how long and how many tears and drops of blood I have sweat into this bill? And now that my son is finally added into this bill, I'm going to be forced to vote or encourage others to vote against it. That is extremely painful for me as a father. But I refuse to allow our governor to get one more ceremonious bill through that he can say he's helping the kids. He's not helping anybody. Nearly all of the parents that are participating in House Bill 1, House Bill 1 doesn't cover them. I mean, we're already felons. We're already breaking federal law. We're already breaking Colorado law or Washington law or Oregon law. It's time to actually help the parents. If you don't want to, that's fine. You know, if you think it's just a bad idea, I'm okay with that. If your legislator thinks it's just a bad idea, it could lead to some bad place. That's okay. I don't have a problem with a legislator voting no. Matter of fact, generally 98% of the time, I respect a no vote a lot more than a yes vote. But have the courage to stand up and vote no. Instead of secretly behind closed doors ripping out every single thing in the bill that matters to the parents and to the patients. Now, I want to leave you with one last thought. Over the past year, I've met countless parents. And as I mentioned before, I get contacted every day with other autistic parents around the world wanting information or telling me the story of their child. I started out telling you about the ugly side of autism, the side that you generally don't see very often. And that's the story of a little 3-year-old girl right up the street from my house whose parents had to strap to the bed and had to put pads on her arms because she was literally chewing her arm off. That's the story of a 15-year-old boy that went to bed completely normal and woke up the next day and started beating his head against the wall. They did studies and they said that the amount of stress that an autistic parent deals with on a daily basis is equal to a combat veteran when it comes to the flashbacks, and terror, and fear, a constant fear. Let me tell you what I go to sleep every night to. Gentle 7-year-old child tapping his head against the wall. He's just tapping. Every night I go to bed with the fear that when I wake up, that's what I'm going to be woken up to. You can't understand that. That's okay. I don't want you to understand it. It's okay that you don't understand it. Be grateful you don't understand it. But give me the opportunity to care for my child. That's all I've got.